spiritually and positively. If you can go to the next slide. This is a group that I love to go hang out with. This is our book club. And Miss Pat, I don't see her here today, but it is an awesome gathering of believers. We talk, we share our lives, we share our struggles, we share our successes, we share experiences, and then we take a book and we read about it and we exegete it and just enjoy and eat and be merry. You want to connect yourself with people that think like you, believe like you, because I believe iron sharpens iron. And when you go around other people that think like you, and that act like you, and believe like you, you can share wisdom and knowledge that can help you both become better people. And this is what the book club does for me. After A.N., nurture yourself daily. I know while we was actually at this book club meeting last month, we got a call that first lady, and I'm sorry, y'all, I'm from a charismatic United Methodist Church, and in that church, if you don't understand the first lady, we recognize our first lady as the pastor's wife. So if I say that, that's I'm talking about Miss Esperanza. And I know it's kind of different in this culture, but we got a call that she went into the hospital, and immediately we stopped and we prayed. And then we sent pictures to the pastor to let him know, hey, we're praying. She's going to be all right. She's in God's hands. It's good to be connected to good people. They make you better. When you're in the wrong, they tell you you're wrong, but they love you back to them. After nurturing ourselves, oh, go back to the other slide. This is very important. In nurturing, these are some points that I just want to share with you all. In the process of nurturing, you got to learn to be yourself. And some of you all, y'all already have mastered that. You know, I was always told, by the time you get in knocking on 40s, it's kind of like you don't care. It's like, hey, you're going to either love me or hate me, you know? But when you're younger, it's harder because we're trying to please and trying to fit in. But when you stay connected with God, He lets you know who you are, so you don't really try to impress people. And I'm going to bring that into this message in a few minutes. But be yourself. Accept and love who you are. Find and do what makes you happy. You may be walking in nature. It may be listening to music. It may just be going to get a massage every now and then. Do what makes you happy. Learn to conquer negative thoughts. Whatever you're going through, anytime a negative thought comes, you gotta cancel it immediately. You have to. It keeps you more healthier. Then you have to exercise. Exercise your mind and your body. Eat healthy. It is true. You are what you eat. You eat healthy, you'll be more healthier. 7, find ways to be grateful. One of my most favorite mentors and motivational speakers of this time, his name is Tony Robbins. And I was fortunate to be able to go to one of his conferences a few months ago in Dallas. And he called this thing called priming yourself. And he does it every morning for 10 minutes. And all it is when he get up, he think of 3 things that he's grateful for. And when you do that, it just puts you in a different mindset. So whenever you face any type of challenges, you just go back and revert to what you're grateful for. Because it's better to be 6 feet above the ground than 6 feet under. 8, contribute to others. Pastor shared so many different ways you can contribute here with under the umbrella of the United Methodist Church. That is a blessing. Contributing, it actually, when you give something to someone else, there are actually chemicals that are released in your body, different endorphins, that make you feel better. So it's healthy to contribute. Do it. It will help your health. You can go to the next D. D, demonstrate faith under pressure. I feel she wanted to give in. She wanted to surrender to the process. So many times we are praying for things, and the reason why I believe God delayed certain blessings is because he's trying to prepare us and make sure we are ready for the blessing. Pastor just talked about Advent. The blessing is coming. But my question, can you stand to be blessed? Can you stand and wait on the blessing? Can you stand and be determined and courageous to say, I don't care what comes or how hard, I'm going to stand. I'm going to believe God. I'm going to trust God. I'm going to stay connected to him. I'm going to pray. And when pressure comes, when challenges come, I will not give in because I know I serve a God that's able. It may not always come the way that I want it to, when I want it to come, but it's going to come. Some of you all quoted, I think it was Mr. Parks, the other week, one time we had a meeting here, and we were talking about the church, and I shared with someone that, you know, I asked them how much money do we need, you know, to make sure everything was good, and I think they mentioned $1 million, and then I said, okay, God can do it. I wasn't just saying that because I didn't know he could do it. I said it because I know that he can do it. But guess what? Experiences teach you certain things. It was in 2000. I was just a sophomore in high school. I mean, I'm a sophomore in college. But I started my record label when I was a senior in college. I had a dream. I had a vision. I had a goal in mind. Because my sister and I, we actually were scouted to sign on a major gospel record label. But the contract they gave us, it was a slave contract. And I didn't sign it. How many high school kids or college kids will just allow a major deal to pass away? But when you're connected to God and you know who you are, you don't give in to anything. So I said no. And that's how my passion grew for me to be able to educate independent artists and national artists on how to take care of their business and to learn the industry and know how to cover themselves. That's how I got into that. That's how it all started. So my senior year, I started my record label. I didn't know how I was going to get the money for me and my sister to release our album. But during that time, it cost between $30,000 to $50,000 to do a good project. And in my young little years, I figured out how to raise the money. I was daddy's girl. So I went to my dad. He told me to put a business plan together. I put the business plan together. I had to dress up in a nice pantsuit and everything. And I had to present my proposal to him. And he was so impressed. But hey, I worked on that. Ooh, I worked on it for about a month. I practiced in front of friends and everything. And do you know my dad went and got a second mortgage on our home? And gave me $50,000 to do the project? And out of that, me and my sister, we just took it to the streets. We were just selling on the road out the trunk of our cars. And we did about 10,000 sales. So, made about $100,000. That was just the first project. So, being that young and being able to see what God can do, what's $1 million with 100 people? Come on. But it teaches you. Faith teaches you. Experience teaches you. So, when God brings people in your life, look at it as a gift. Because they may be bringing experiences to you that would help catapult you to to your next level of faith. Turn to your neighbor real quick and say, we're in this together. Last point, the title of this message was, can you stand and be blessed? You can stand and be blessed. All you got to do is stay plugged into the power source. T, trust God over fear. A, associate with other believers. N, nurture yourself daily. D, demonstrate faith under pressure. Hannah got what she wanted, but it was in God's timing. She got what she wanted. And even though Peninnah provoked her sorely, I don't think she sat back and thought about that after she was holding that baby Samuel. She didn't care. Some of these storms you're going through, frustrations you're going through, trust me, when you get to what God wants you to be and you have what you've been praying for, you're not going to care about. You're going to look back and just say, God, I don't know how I got over it. I did it without praying. So be encouraged on today. Right where you are, you're right on schedule. You're right where you need to be. So just trust the process. You can stand.